Hi, my name's Laura, and this is my channel, Life After 50. I thought a lot about doing a YouTube channel, and I thought, I don't know, this really isn't for me. Well, to begin with, let's start. I never watched YouTube, really, for any reason. And one day I was streaming channels and Keeping It Dutch came on. And I started watching them, and then I started watching them a little bit more, and then I started watching Arms Family Homestead. And I was just like kind of caught up in it. I've lived in the same place for 20 years, and I live on 4 acres of land, which basically we never did anything with. My husband passed away 10 years ago, so I've been here at this house by myself. And in between, I have my kids living with me. They're older now, and they have the kids of their own. I have 6 grandkids that I love with all my heart. And that led me to watching The Crockers. And I got more interested, especially with this virus going on, in maybe I could do something here. Well, about a year ago, I decided I needed to sell this place. I couldn't keep up with the upkeep, the maintenance of it. It was just overwhelming. I have heart failure, and for a long time didn't know if I was going to need a heart transplant or not. I ended up having my pacemaker removed and a device called a CRT put in, which basically works 100% of the time, which really brought a lot back to my life. I'm able to do a lot more than I was prior to that. Well, my house is on the market for 5 months, and my son and his wife around this time had just purchased a home of their own, and they were living in an apartment prior to that, and they have 3 kids. Well, my daughter and her husband were living in an apartment, and she approached me with an offer of, would you consider selling the house to us if we allowed you to stay there and live out the rest of your life? Well, I had to give it some thought because I was originally thinking moving closer to town, smaller yard, just able to, you know, less upkeep and maintenance. Well, around that same time is when I found out that my heart was at 30% and I could be looking at it transplant. And there were a lot of things going on with my life, and so I thought about it, thought, well, this, you know, this could be really good for both of us. So I decided that we'd give that a shot. Well, in the meantime, my daughter got pregnant again. She has 2 boys, and she's pregnant, and she's due here shortly, within like the next month. So we decided that on the lower level of the house, we would put in like a small area for me. Really keep things simple, not a whole lot of living space, but just, you know, enough. What do we really need? You know, there's so much that you think, I gotta have this, I gotta have that, but do you really need to have that? And so right now, we're kind of in a mess in a menagerie with this property. But back in the spring when this virus came out, and this is where it goes back to Dutch, and I gotta thank him, I decided to get some chickens. So I thought it'd be a good experience for my 2 grandsons that live here with me to get to raise them and learn about taking care of an animal that way. So it's with the intentions of producing eggs for the family. So we have 8 chickens, which I'll get into in later videos and walk you through, show you the different things around the house. But so I'm gonna walk you through the construction of making me a smaller space so I can live comfortably, but I'm giving up the whole house. I'm going from a full house to this smaller area. But I am looking forward to it. And the best part of it is that 2 or 3 to come here shortly, and my grandkids will be basically living in the same house as me, and we're going to be getting to spend more time with them. We also started a garden, which I have never done. Well, I say garden, but it's a lot of planters and things like that. But I also give that to the credit of watching all the Keeping in Touch, Arms Family Home, the Sawyers. Wow, the Sawyers. And I watch all these channels now, and I've like got so many goals. And basically, I was planning my life to how it's gonna die, and wanting to spend as much time with my grandkids that I could, and my kids. And I have a son, Gage, and daughter, Taylor, and I love them to death, and they're my whole world. And so I wasn't planning a life. I wasn't living. I was planning my death. And now that's changed so much. And thank you, Dutch, for just allowing me to watch your channels. And I watched a lot when I couldn't do anything. I couldn't walk up some steps. I also, sorry about that. The same year in 2015, I had found out that I have heart failure. But in the same year, within 3 months, it was discovered at Cleveland Clinic that I had brain aneurysm, and I needed surgery for that. Bad year, let me tell you. But I had a stroke afterwards, and I'm still, I use the cane, but I'm doing so much better than prior to all that. I worked full time. I did scheduling for a home health and hospice agency, but that was all gone. I summed up all my FMLA and, you know, couldn't do it. So now that I'm planning to live a life, I decided I'm going to start this YouTube channel, and I'm going to show my life after 50. And I really hope that people are interested and want to walk this journey with me. And if you are, you can subscribe to my channel. I'd appreciate if you hit that like button. Just see if I have to offer. And we'll kind of go from there. But it's this is my first vlog, so I hope that I get better with time with them. But in the meantime, I'm going to end this vlog, and it was so nice talking to everybody, and if you like it, give me a like. Okay.